Oh, that's not good. Our radios are
talking
not secure.
Sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
And it's pretty incriminating, too.
Sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No.
Don't freak out. Calm down. Don't let the tequila get you.
Oh, my God. What the fuck is happening, Henry?
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Well, I guess we're just going to jump to tomorrow, then. It was pretty late. Yeah, I think that is definitely happening. Maybe shouldn't keep...
So your little bender isn't looking like such a good idea under the light of a new day, huh?
I'm bringing Shelley Duvall with me. This place doesn't seem good.
Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire.
Somebody's fucking with us.
I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it.
Is that my
Furthermore,
ring?
I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
Us? What's this us? You're the boss. I was just...
What, following orders?
Hey, I didn't burn down anybody or kill any kids.
Tell them the truth, right? That's all you can do.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
I have a lot of information here. Yeah, this us stuff. You're getting a little... What is this? Where'd that cassette recorder go? That would be pretty helpful for... Or is this the tape? Okay. Do other copies exist? Okay, so that was the cassette tape I was just listening to. Because, apparently, that old Shoshone song exists somewhere. And with this cassette tape player, maybe, just maybe, I could listen to that. But apparently it's tacked to a tree or something, and I don't know where that is, so. Oh, this is not looking good. This is looking pretty bad. Why am I going around with my wedding ring off? That's quite strange as well, but I got that. I got Shelley Duvall, and I have my bottle of whiskey, just in case. It's my only true memento, that bottle of whiskey. I want to head to the cave, so... Yeah, so if I head west and take that path that way, then I will be laughing. Beautiful. And let's see if, well, heading to this cave where I mysteriously acquired the key for it from a strange figure that ended up leaving cassette tape with incriminating evidence that apparently this fire was started maliciously, in part by me and my supervisor. That's... Okay, nope. Turn too soon. Damn it. Need to head further. Just cut through the tree line over here, and... yeah. If I cut through this way, either I'm going to find something impassable and have to backtrack to the trail before, earlier... Or I will be able to cut through and get onto a northern path that'll leave me to the cave. Just going about at the speed of sound and I'm about my outhouse right in time. And so I want to head solid north to get back to the cave, which means I gotta climb down all this stuff again. Yeah, sounds good. Drop down, hop and hop. You know, this is just a recipe for disaster of just busting your ankle right open. It's just like, watch my kneecaps explode as I hop off this stuff like a hero. Ah! I don't imagine the game will suddenly get incredibly graphic like that, but you never truly know what occurrence may come out from that. Okay, so if I hop down here, then it should be just a simple twisting and winding.
Hey,
wait.
You didn't actually make that call.
Okay.
Right?
Hey, come on now.
It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kind of just wish I hadn't.
Yeah, that's kind of a shitty thing.
Of course no. They didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
They're messing with us.
Yeah.
Don't let them tear us apart.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
Don't worry, I had moments where I distrusted you, too. So now the paranoia is getting to you and you're distrusting me. I understand, Delilah. I don't appreciate the accusation, but I'm not gonna hold it against you because, I had the same moment of weakness myself as well. Okay, we've made it to K452. Now that we have a key for it, should I not, like, report in that I'm here? I don't think it really matters. And boom! Open. Okay. So what am I going to find in here?
What the hell?
No, 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 no. Oh... Nah, it's just a win, that's all.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave.
Oh, shit.
Is this thing working?
Oh, shit, oh, shit, oh, no,
Delilah,
shit.
Delilah, send someone to the cave, please!
Oh, this is not...
Any damn reception.
Oh, god damn it. Well, it was a trap. Oh, lovely, lovely. It was a horrible, awful, godforsaken trap. Use Polanski. Roman, help me! Shafts of light. Cracks in the rock I can squeeze through there. Can I... I can't get down here.
Jesus,
long, steep drop. And without a latch on point, I can't get down that, so... Quite the crack. I guess I'll just squeeze through here then. And hopefully... find a way out of this death trap. Thank God I had Polanski with me. Ooh, that would have been bad. Very, very bad. And what do we have around here? Oh, yeah. No. No, thank you one bit. I will gladly have nothing to do with sticking down in this cave longer than I have to. That's no good. Jesus. Oh?
Is anybody down there?
Oh. I'm not the only one who's been down here. That's unsettling. Very unsettling. No other, like, random clothing around here, right? It's always a good idea. Or always something that I look forward to not finding is other random clothing. Seems to be making progress. You know, I just remembered I have a flashlight. Haven't really been using it a lot. I've actually kind of completely forgotten about it. Okay, it seems like I found a way out. Excellent. Oh, the fire seems like it's getting really bad. Very, very, really bad. Delilah?
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Because someone tried to trap me in there.
Yes.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
Yeah, I would have probably died in there.
No, there's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Hello.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Wow, that's an interesting assumption to jump to.
A real castle.
fortress wall.
Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
A dragon. And a shield.
Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe and he made it because he was afraid of them.
5 degrees north.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get
Richard
sick to my
Sturgeon.
Stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow.
Go ahead, kill my family.
Everyone
makes
this guy
me stronger.
Loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband, which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's fucking dark.
Goodwin family crest.
But he was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. It's a little
banners.
Weird that he just leaves so much of his stuff out here.
Interesting.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left.
Toy
like
dinosaur.
I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied, and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Wizards and wizards.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
D&D, like crazy.
I found a
Gladius Sylvia
sheet for one
chaotic
Gladius
good
half elf armor
ranger. Wait,
135.
Sounds
like
age.
Yeah, between this and the map I found in my tower, old Brian created quite the fantasy world.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved.
Battle axe, throwing dagger, long sword, short sword. Ha. Huh. I'll hold on to that.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Radio Goodwin,
yeah,
with Brian and
Ned.
300 watts, too high.
You know,
pass maximum voltage.
Stuff like that.
Which is a bit working. Not conventional. Interesting. No, shit, I wanted to keep that. Give me the diagram. Thank you. Got a little too overzealous there. Note to Ranger. Postcard. Let's take a look at that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
Dear Mr. Zuckler.
He's with his dad, and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Lander, Wyoming. It's pretty neat.
And also, he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, absolutely.
That doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
He was a shitty dad, hey? I'm with my dad in Lander, Wyoming. It's pretty neat. Dad, something in a spot called Sinks Canyon. Most of Wyoming looks like home in Nebraska, but then there are mountains and woods where when you go far. I'm sorry I can't mow your lawn this summer, but I hope you found a good person to do it instead. Can you write back and tell my dad when school starts? Because I don't think he knows. Your friend and neighbor, Brian Goodwin. 29 Willow Street, North Platte, Northeast. Hold on to that. Hand-drawn schematic.
Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
Spook I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Control.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
Magnet
it's some
hook.
Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
Isn't that adorable? And good drawing, too. Backpack retrieval plan, Mark 4. To get boards, 4 to 6. Rope, sorrow, rocks, 15. Tools, borrow. Pack contents, my rope, our camera. Oh, so this. That may have, science homework.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Interesting.
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Are you saying I'm a knucklehead?
I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
Oh, no,
because
I put the
I
idea... And the doubt in her mind.
Please drown me in your surplus of knowledge. I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
Well, that wait's over, sweetheart.
Call me sweetheart again, and you'll use that big sexy brain of yours to fill out your unemployment paperwork.
Hey, come on now, don't get on boss. About the sexual harassment. So what we got here? Brian Goodwin, Hamilton Science Fair, Rough Draft, Miss McNamara, 6th grade, April 4th, 1986. Talking meteors. How ham radio waves can use meteors to talk to people far away. Avoid second person, it's too controversial for science. What if I told you that you could... use... put that in a couple too many times. Meteors in our atmosphere to talk to people far away. You would probably think I was a liar, but you would be wrong. Meteors, the alien rocks that came from our planet, that come to our planet from outer space, can be used to bounce ham radio waves off of and off of what? And let you use your radio much better than normal. Right now, you're thinking, okay, Brian, this sounds like a movie, like Flight of the Navigator. It's not real, but you're wrong. It is real. It is science. It is possible because of meteor scatter communications. My science fair project proves that the meteor scatter communications is real. But what is it? Notice that. What it is. MSC, meteor scatter communications, is a radio propagation mode that utilizes the ionized trails of meteors within our atmosphere. Meteors upon their atmospheric entry can create a dense path of ionized particles that the ham radio operator can use to establish brief communication paths between operators up to 1,000 miles away? I think there's a correction on that. Are these your own words, Brian? Interesting. It's pretty cool. I'm going to test this by having a small chat with a friend my dad made in the Army who lives in Albuquerque, New Mexico, 1,000 miles away from my house. We are going to try to talk at a regular time, but my hypothesis is that that won't work, and we will have to wait for a meteor shower so we can establish a communication. He is a pretty smart kid.
I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
That's a Freddy Krueger. You're dead. Brian Goodwin. Oh, that is a Trapper Keeper kid's notebook, absolutely. The Draculos Lord. Draculords. Gladius Silva, yeah, his D&D character. Can I... A folder that once held school papers and reports presumably defaced by Brian Goodwin. Wait, have I had thoughts on a majority of this stuff as well? Okay, it seems like I'm freaking out on the physics on something here. I don't know what. One second here. Dear Ranger, hi, my name is Brian Goodwin. If you found this note, it should be with a bunch of climbing anchors. I hope could you do me a favor and return them to me? Brian Goodwin in the mail. My address is 55 Foxtrot Lane, North Pallet, Nebraska. If you tell me your name and address, I would give you a reward for this. You are probably wondering why I left these here. Well, they're my dad's. I don't want to loose them. But I don't want to do any more climbing on this trip, so I thought I should pretend to lose them. But if you help me get them back, everyone will be happy. Thank you for your time. Thank you, Ranger Brian. P.S. The reward will be good.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear. His anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was going to hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. He left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. It sounds like Ned was... pushing him and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
So Ned was a little bit of a scumbag then, you say? Over by the... a bit far north. So if I can navigate a bit west, I can get back on the trail and be back at the cave there, because that crack in that rock looked familiar. Damn it. To the crack in the rock that I'd seen over by that very steep incline.
What do you think is in there?
gotta be something. Why else try to kill me? I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
Come on, let's not get too graphic.
God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Are you serious with this shit right now?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Okay, I still have quite a distance to go down here. Alright. I thought I was a lot closer than I actually was, but... turns out I still have like a kilometer or so. Oh, I still have my goddamn flashlight on. Jesus. That's how you burn out the batteries.
So those girls turn. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did.
No, I told you I never killed them.
Farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and landed in jail.
Goddamn ignorant teenagers.
Yeah, I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever happened at their camp.
I think we'd be smart to let sleeping dogs lie.
I guess. Okay, back into 452, and hopefully nobody sneaks up behind me again and tries to lock me in. I'm watching you, Gate. Actually, no, if they left me in here, maybe they've taken off for sure? A piton crack. I don't think that's the proper way of pronouncing that. Alright, let's rappel down here. See what the hell's... why I was locked in here in the first place. Was it just to leave me to die? Which seems like a cruel and unusual fate. Jesus. Why? Or... what? I guess we'll find out in a moment, perhaps. Or we'll find nothing. And it'll all be for naught. Or maybe it'll reveal the big secret of... the evil corporation and their nefarious doings down in this cave, where they've been conducting experiments on rats and all kinds of things. Oh, it's just moss. Okay, shit. I'm like, that looks like a lot of blood, but no, it's just moss. Where in the hell am I going? I guess I'm going down, down. Are you in or are you out? Sugar, we're going down swinging. Yeah, music's picking up. No, well, keep going. Come on, there has to be some sort of revelation down here, I would think. I'd imagine. But what? Oh,
shit.
Ryan.
Oh, God. You fell. Stuff to keep out. Poor fucking kid. You're Brian Goodwin.
No. He died. Stepping over the poor boy. That was 3 years ago. Jesus. So, if Brian Goodwin died here, never made it back home, then... what the hell happened to Ned? Did Ned... well, of course Ned knew that his boy went missing, but... that's... strange? No, not strange, but that's... that leaves quite an open-ended conundrum in my mind. Like, if Ned... oh, poor kid. Jesus. Must have fallen down from over there. So how does this all loop back around on itself? Or if I... jeez. So, wait. Did Ned just leave after his son went missing? Or did he possibly stay behind? Searching for his boy. And everybody thought they left and he's been living out in the woods all this time with his shame and his guilt? No, that seems a little far-fetched. I don't know. Hopefully the game will give a little bit of insight in that. Oh, seems like I'm making it back to the gate? Oh yeah, long drive. Okay. Well, that's some beautiful level design right there. I really like that. brings me right back around. And as soon as I climb up here, I will be able to inform Delilah of the most tragic goddamn thing in the world. Oh.
Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Yeah, it gets worse.
Hey, you might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
Good. Very good.
Only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah.
Yeah.
It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me.
I wish I was.
What? I don't...
Yeah. How? Three years.
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm. No.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave.
He's not really rotting anymore. He's pretty desiccated.
I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Yeah, judging from this smoke, it seems like a really good idea that we probably should leave tomorrow. Man, I packed up all my stuff thinking that anyone... Okay, now I got my typewriter. Just gonna jam that in my bag. Gotta make sure I grab my whiskey, pack up belongings. You can keep that, absolutely. Wow, got all this stuff. Tracking device. Keep that.
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained. Way.
Is this the flapjack fire or the site fire? Or?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed
That's
up?
That's
shouldn't we talk
almost.
For a second? No. About things?
About
no,
what?
I want the mug. About what happened,
about what
Brian.
Happened to
I don't have much to say. I'm fine. I'm sad. I'm whatever. I keep thinking about him down there, and I just want to get far away from here.
Yeah, it seems like a really good idea.
We just have to wait for the helicopters.
Okay.
Until then, could you follow that signal?
Shelly!
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
We don't know what
it is. Another signal?
It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was kind of hoping you'd have a plan.
Have a backup plan or something.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
Oh!
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right.
Yeah, that'd be kind of helpful.
I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
Why is my photo of Julia still on the goddamn floor? That seems like a horrible place to keep that. Okay, I'm happy that I grabbed that photo of Julia. Ooh, this seems real bad. This seems like it's getting horribly bad out here. Okay, let's follow the signal. Hopefully it doesn't take me too far into the depths of the fire. The two fires merged together, hey? That's real shit. Follow this west. I don't know if, no, it's getting weaker. But it doesn't seem to be that direction. No. Come on. Pick up the signal a little better. Or... Oh. That seemed a little stronger. Yeah. That definitely seems stronger. Is it bringing me back to the cave again? Maybe. Yeah, that's picking up, Okay. No, that's weaker. Little stronger, little weaker, little stronger. No, that's gotten pretty weak again. Hell, I've never gone through there before. Well, that was fun. Yeah, that seems like progress. Beep, beep, beep. Seems like it's taking me towards Jonesy Lake.